Following with important breaking news tonight, closely monitoring now a report from a flight tracking website that is now showing multiple flights diverted over Iranian airspace. Iranian news is now reporting an explosion was heard northwest of a city named Isfahan. The cause of this explosion is still unknown.
This city is a city that has multiple military bases around it and also has one of Iran's principal nuclear research facilities.
号称是可以超音速攻击的征服者极音速飞弹。就在对以色列发动攻击的五天后，伊朗办起盛大阅兵。
今年由于受到近期伊以对峙的影响，将阅兵仪式选择在军事基地。这一方面是出于安全因素的考虑，另一方面则体现出伊朗的军方已经做好准备来应对任何可能发生的威胁。
特别仪式东部基地举行，伊朗大秀火药库深度，这也令华府智库警告不可低估。
Well, Aaron, the Iranian arsenal is the most formidable, I think, in the Middle East. The Iranians have ballistic and cruise missiles, including the Sumar, which can reach 2,000 to 3,000 kilometers.
包含 S-300 防空系统、各式的短中程飞弹，还有侦察及攻击型无人机、三军方阵等等。 伊朗明显是想借由阅兵再度激怒以色列。伊朗总统莱西在层层军力围安下现身，呛瞎以色列。
If the Zionist regime makes the slightest move to violate our territory and harm the national interests of the Islamic Republic, they must understand that they will face a severe and heavy response.
警告千万不要轻言报复，还大酸西方国家。
The Al-Aqsa storm operation and Operation True Promise crumbled the Zionist regime's aura of invincibility. It proved that the strength of the Zionist regime and its backers are comparable to the strength of a spider's web.
军车上还秀出要打倒美国的铁拳图样，再拉高了仇美情绪。而以色列被打之后，将近一个礼拜迟迟没有回应，到底在顾虑什么？
The Iranians have upwards of 200,000 missiles and rockets in Lebanon right now that Hezbollah has and could shoot from Lebanese territory and would frankly overwhelm Israel's air defense system.
伊朗扶持的代理人几乎是包围以色列，前有恶灵威胁，后有西方国家的层层劝说。
Looking into sanctions, my position is that the Iranian Revolutionary Guard should be put on a sanction list, and it would be.
And we feel it's very important to do everything to isolate Iran.
欧美倾向先外交后军事，也就是先以制裁为主，军事手段能免则免，但是以色列恐怕很难轻轻放下。
And the Israeli military believes this missile was likely intercepted. You can see the holes in the sides of this fuel tank. This missile was actually found in the Dead Sea. It was recovered and it was taken to this base in southern Israel. But now Israel says it must respond. It must reestablish deterrence.
对纳坦雅胡政府来说，压力在于内部主战派的声浪是越来越强烈了。
Prime Minister Netanyahu, you have to be strong.
在伊朗4月13号攻击之前，以色列的民间示威多半是希望政府缓下加萨战火，换回人质。但现在舆论风向180度大转变。 极右派民众更拿二战时的两颗原子弹来类比，希望以色列能够全面开战。只是两场战事根本不能比，以色列终究面对的是伊朗代理人虎视眈眈的现实。
If we cannot establish the new normal is every time we go into Syria, Iran gets to drop what they just dropped on us last weekend. So we have to respond.
如果以色列的回击规模太小，可能就此被视为软脚虾；太重，又可能扩大变成中东战争，而这势必让现在对加萨哈马斯的战事更难收场。
Is that only 52% of the people believe the prime minister can bring the hostages home? This is a divided country.
因为还有大批人质没救回来，但是现在这时机点也不可能和哈马斯谈停火条件。
There is one solution, very clear, very simple, but it's not politically correct.
What's your solution?
Air Force, clean all Gaza.
有音乐祭死者的家属直言，希望以军夷平加萨，再凸显出以色列民意的分歧。这也让纳坦雅胡现在只能走一步算一步。
He wants to prolong the war.
对哈马斯战事没完，也还没对伊朗反击。而现在在与黎巴嫩交界，又是互轰不断，以色列的处境进退两难。 TVBS
新闻综合报道，观众朋友晚安，欢迎一起来Focus全球新闻，关注的是中东战事，伊朗在上个周末攻击了以色列，现在国际关注以色列会不会有进一步的报复行动。星期三，以色列战时内阁召开第三次会议，严厉反击。美国情报单位透露，以色列 会在伊朗境内采取有限的军事行动，而美国也对伊朗寄出制裁。欧盟计划会扩大对伊朗的惩罚。以色列不愿意停火，全球对以哈战争谴责以色列的声浪不断。美国谷歌的员工发起示威，抗议公司跟以色列政府合作发展的 AI 技术被运用在加萨战场上，成为种族屠杀的工具。有部分参与计划的工程师因为承受不了内心的压力， 从谷歌辞职。伊朗上周末发射超过300枚飞弹和无人机攻击以色列，中东情势一触即发。国际也紧盯以色列的报复行动。周三，以国战时内阁召开第三次会议，研讨反击行动。尽管行动内容还不明朗，但美国情报单位透露， 以色列会采取有限的军事行动，预料会在伊朗境内进行。
We will respond the way that we will choose at the time that we will choose. We don't just have offensive capabilities who were proven on Saturday night.
以色列从死海打捞到伊朗飞弹的残骸，军方立刻向国际媒体展示这些原本只有在伊朗阅兵大典上才有机会看到的武器。
And at 36 feet long, this is just the fuel tank for that missile. The Israeli military says more than 120 ballistic missiles were fired at Israel in this attack, only a handful of them actually making it through Israel's air defense systems. And the Israeli military believes this missile was likely intercepted. You can see the holes in the sides of this fuel tank.
专家分析，以色列的报复行动可能包含网络骇客攻击以及飞弹袭击伊朗城市和军事机构。
For example, you could have the attack some of the naval installations that are on the coast here. You could attack some of the airfields that are in these parts of Iran. So there's several things, several options that the Israelis have.
以色列还没出手，美国倒是先对伊朗寄出了制裁。财政部长耶伦宣布，将针对伊朗的武器、无人机计划以及资助伊朗军事行动的企业和单位进行制裁。
The attack by Iran and its proxies underscores the importance of Treasury's work to use our economic tools to counter Iran's malign activity.
欧盟也计划扩大对伊朗的经济制裁。之前，伊朗提供俄罗斯武器已经受到惩罚，欧盟将进一步对飞弹发展和运送武器到代理国家黎巴嫩、也门、伊拉克和叙利亚的行动实施制裁。伊朗这波攻击让以军对加萨的炮火稍稍停歇。 尽管以色列并未公布可以返家的讯息，但加萨北部数千名逃离的居民已经迫不及待地朝回家的路前进。民众在检查哨遭到以军的射击，造成不少孩童死伤。I
just want to go home. If I die, so be it.
以色列不愿意停火，全球谴责声浪不断。美国加州谷歌的工程师发起示威，抗议公司和以色列政府合作开发云端 AI 技术 Nimbus。
So I would not like to lose my job, but I think it is impossible for me to continue coming into work every week without acknowledging and loudly condemning Project Nimbus.
抗议员工大多遮脸掩饰身份，因为上个月初，一名谷歌工程师在一场纽约研讨会上高喊拒绝替以色列制造用于种族灭绝和监控的技术。事后，这名工程师被开除。
I am not proud to work for Google. I am ashamed to work for Google. And the only reason I am still working for Google is because of my fellow workers at No Tech for Apartheid organizing against Nimbus and against tech complicit in genocide.
不少员工还占领谷歌云端执行长的办公室，并为遭歧视对待的穆斯林同事发声。他们指控谷歌为以色列发展人脸辨识、物件追踪等 AI 技术，最后应用到加萨战场上。还有一些参与计划的工程师受不了心理的压力而离职。
Through Project Nimbus, it is clear to me that Google values money over people's lives.
We've already had some Googlers resign, citing that Project Nimbus was the main concern for their poor mental health and was the reason why they had to leave Google.
No more money for Israel!
反以色列示威周一也让纽约通勤族上班迟到，15名挺巴勒斯坦的民众封锁桥梁，造成上班尖峰时间大塞车。
I would love a ceasefire as well, but as a traveler, I'm very frustrated that this is how they're choosing to ask for it.
以色列对伊朗的报复牵动全球安全，联合国原子能监督机构就警告以色列有可能攻击伊朗的核设施，周一已经要求联合国的检察员先行离开。 TVBS 新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。